Fuckers, one more time, thank you for coming here and inspiring so many survivors.
Walking one way is more than enough. Jeez. I just wanted to quickly, while Patrick's still standing up, I heard him speak yesterday, and it's just, wow, so much wisdom in such a young man. And thank you for sharing your story, sharing your wisdom, and just being a role model to also us older people as well. So it gives us light, gives us hope that there's light at the end of the tunnel because we see our youth healing from residential school. So thank you to Patrick, and thank you to all the youth that are here today. Sheesh.
So I just wanted to tell you a quick story about when I was dating my husband in Vancouver. His name is Derek Yap. I'm sorry, I'm married. Anyways, when we were dating, you know, early on and after, you know, after a few weeks, he's like, I got something to tell you. I'm like, oh, here we go. There's always something, right? And I'm like, okay, what is it? Because I'm going to be going to theology school next year. What? I said, God, when I was single, God, please send me a spiritual man. I didn't mean a United Church minister. Well, I had these flashes of me sitting with a hat and white gloves, sitting in church, trying to be good. Being awake on Sunday morning.
Baking pies for the church bake sale.
Ladies auxiliary. I had her life all mapped out. But I won. He quit theology school.
Is it Jezebel? Is she corrupted him?
He's been clinketized. Oh, but the church is still important part of our life, and we're actually members of the United Church and in Whitehorse, and we were married at the United Church in the Tezen Klinget Heritage Center. So I'm really happy, I was really happy to stand up with all our United Church congregation yesterday and to hear your expression of reconciliation. I had hoped to come talk to the speakers. I couldn't find you, so during the feast, I would love if you could come talk to me. I'd like to meet you. So, thank you.
When she first brought Derek home to Teslin, she brought him over to meet my mom, one of her aunties. And my mom's just smiling and smiling. Derek is half Asian, half white. And when he left, when both of them left, then my mom, there's no one in the house, but she's still whispering, how old is he? Because he looks a lot younger than he is. He's only, what, 4 years younger than her? But he looked like he was 20.
I am a cougar.
Surprise,
he looked young.
Surprised my mom didn't ask, does he have a brother?
Oh, then he, when we're getting to know each other, he told me about his first degree that he had. I'm like, oh yeah, that makes sense. Then his second degree that he had, and I'm like, how old are you? Yeah. His third degree, I was like, holy smokes, Doogie Howser. And then he was working on his fourth degree at the theology school, but I give him the fifth degree.
I just wanted to share quickly some good news I just received, just right before I came on stage. My oldest, his name's Ray, he's been... He also is a survivor, because I'm a survivor of a survivor, so those intergenerational effects of residential school. He's had been dealing with alcohol issues. Last night he rolled a truck, drinking and driving, and so luckily he's not hurt, there's no one else hurt. But today he's finally made that choice to go to treatment. Also is a youth who's also a role model and setting a good example for all of us. So thank you, our creator. Thank all of you for all your love and support. So today's a good day. Sheesh. Now let's eat. Where's Janelle?
Sorry, we're just confused about something. But we'd like to thank the honorary witnesses and Alan for offering for the cedar box, so you're now released from duty. But I wanted to acknowledge the teepees that you've seen here at TRC. Aren't they beautiful? The one at the fire and the one here. And there's a young man who I met yesterday who was actually the one who set up these teepees. And by himself, by the way. He's from member two. His name is Cameron Paul. Are you here, Cameron? Stand up wherever you are. Actually, come up to the stage. Commissioner's calling for you. Is he here?
He's all by himself at the top.
Yeah, the commissioner would like me to come up on stage to acknowledge. Also, he told me that last year he was a teepee builder for the member two event, which was something like 17 teepees, and I heard it was an amazing thing to see. Oh, here comes Cameron. This young man, 26. He was telling me how he put the teepee up by himself. It's pretty amazing. And I've been inside that teepee with Commissioner Sinclair.
He's going to give us an example of how he does it. He's going to take it down and put it back up in 2 minutes.
Thank you very much. You give a big hand for Cameron.
You can start just getting the people on stage. Sharon and I are just going to, yeah, I'm being waved over again. Okay.
I've had a couple friends who live in Halifax, and they're not native. One of them is a musician who I met at a festival close to Whitehorse. And he's been coming and participating and watching and witnessing. And one of the things that he had mentioned to me is that it was such a rare sight, but a happy sight to see all the First Nation people, Inuit and Métis, who've been pouring all over Halifax, downtown Halifax this week. And so I just thought that was a great observation. And I've been really happy to hear a lot of the non-natives who have participated and who are really interested in what's happening here.
So after dinner, we're going to go across the street and we're going to occupy the Occupy Halifax.
Yeah! Yeah! Yeah!
We're going to camp out, we're going to have a powwow.
And take back your land.
We're going to take back.
Yeah.
Take back.
Well, I hope they do get it back for the Remembrance Day ceremonies that are going to happen.
There's a few things I noticed. I've been back here quite a few times because my dad's family's from here. And there's a lot of sunfires over here in Nova Scotia. Pontiac sunfires. It's like, were they giving them away in cereal boxes? And the funniest thing was, my very first car I owned, I didn't even know about Pontiac Sunfires. Very first car I owned, 2008. Can you guess what it was? Pontiac Sunfire. It's genetic. It's that Cape Breton thing. It must be drawn to the Pontiac Sunfire. I've got to have one behind.
You're pretty proud of it, too.
Oh, yeah. It's pretty. going to be doing the closing ceremony in just a couple of minutes. We're just waiting for them to gather the people and bring them up.